We are back here with another adventures game. I recorded a game before this one, but it was really just about rebuild, so I decided to get another game for today. Looking at the board now, you'll see ball and training as the events, the caravan guard, magpie, hireling, royal carriage as the adventures cards here. Immediately my eye went to Magpie and Royal Carriage as a source of plus actions, and Hunting Grounds to draw cards. Also, Hireling was there to draw cards. So, some kind of engine is possible. I took note of Theodom in case that's relevant somehow, because there's Explorer, Mine, there's even Taxman. You could conceivably increase the number of silvers in your deck more quickly than usual. But I didn't think that would be a big factor. I thought Brigand, Noble Brigand there, would be a decent enough factor anyway, because it seems like the deck is going to be heavily treasure based, and the Brigand steals those treasures away from you. So I was thinking about that in my opening here. And I didn't plan to open with Noble Brigand. I was actually considering here between Caravan Guard and Magpie to open, or between Magpie and Silver. I wanted to get to 5 to get to the Royal Carriages. They were going to be crucial to anything meaningful happening, I think. And because I thought they were that important, I got a Silver instead of the Caravan Guard. And well, Magpie is a very natural opening, very good opening. My opponent here opens a little bit differently, going for Silver Noble Brigand. I was surprised when he opened Noble Brigand. He also managed to skip my Magpie and nick my Silver that I initially bought. So now I'm thinking about how to counter this Noble Brigand, how to play so that I don't just lose to repeated early Noble Brigand plays. So here I thought about buying Magpie. I thought about replacing my Silver, maybe even a Caravan Guard, given that the Noble Brigand has already been bought. Instead, I opted for a Noble Brigand, thinking that it would eventually be useful. I'm rewarded with a Silver, so that's good, at least. My opponent here now gets a Magpie, and I go for Caravan Guard here. I'm hesitant to buy Silver, lest the Noble Brigand steal it, and the Caravan Guard can trigger off the Noble Brigand play. Here I play a Magpie and do not pick up a treasure, but it's fine, I get a Magpie out of it. With 5 here, I think this is an easy call to get a Royal Carriage. Mine you definitely don't want against Noble Brigand. It'll increase your money density and just make the Noble Brigand make its job easier. Here I get to react my Caravan Guard, so I'm extremely happy about that. The Noble Brigand misses. I play my Noble Brigand here and well, skip a couple coppers, so they're not great cards aside from that early exchange. Here I have 5 and buy another Royal Carriage. Again, Explorer just gives Noble Brigand more targets, although it is better than Mine and Taxman, both of which just make your deck richer. It replaces the coppers with silvers and golds, whereas Explorer adds silvers and golds to your deck. So I play my Magpie here, it misses, so I get another Magpie, and this second Magpie also misses. I was hoping to get to 6 here, especially given that I started with a Magpie and $5 in hand. However, that was not to be. Not too bad though, you can never be too unhappy when you gain 2 Magpies in a turn, I think. So again on 5 here, I'm thinking about it'll probably be between Royal Carriage and Explorer. Maybe Ball even, but I opt for the Royal Carriage at this point. Again, I think it's extremely important, a throne room on call, especially in this type of deck where there's no way to get rid of your treasures. You have to wait for an opportunistic moment to see all your action cards to, fully make use of that throne room. So like here I might make use of it, depending on how much money I draw off these magpies. So I have $3 right now. I'll play another magpie. It misses, so I gain more magpies. Here I'm thinking, yeah, $4 is not a great amount of money, which is what I have with the Noble Brigand, so I decided to call this Royal Carriage on my magpie. That misses too, so I still have $4, I think. So I have to call another Royal Carriage on this Noble Brigand just to get the money, really, not to land any attacks or so. Just to get up to 5. This point, I think I go for an explorer. That seemed dubious at best in my head. I wasn't sure if that was the right thing. I probably should have just gone for Royal Carriage again. Especially with how the late game played out. Instead, I think I took the explorer here because I was thinking, okay, the magpies are soon out. I have a bunch of them right now. Maybe I could pick up the silvers, make the magpies have a nice life, make them more reliable. Here, I think I lose another silver to the Noble Brigand. My opponent called the Royal Carriage on it, so they got two plays out of it. Set aside a Royal Carriage here. Get a magpie in play. I'm going to play this second magpie and see if I want to call this Royal Carriage. I do, because I don't have money to buy anything meaningful. My opponent now has two Noble Brigands. So again, I'm just keeping that in mind, trying to play as treasureless as possible here. I finally get to 6. I managed to buy a hunting ground, so that's good for me. I'm glad about that. And here my opponent buys a taxman. So they have 3 attacks in their deck now. 2 brigands and a taxman. So this is just something to keep in mind. Here, no money in hand yet. I finally draw a noble brigand with the magpie. So here I'm thinking about my options. I can call the Royal Carriage on this magpie and be able to play both my terminals as an option. And I do call the Royal Carriage on the magpie, which draws a magpie and a copper. Play this magpie, look at how much money I have again. Realize that I probably don't need to call anything. I have enough money as is after playing the Noble Brigand and the Explorer. So here, in light of the 3 attacks that my opponent has, I'm going to buy a ball and take 2 caravan guards. So I have 3 caravan guards in my deck now, and I expect them to trigger fairly reliably. Even if they don't trigger, it's fine. Here, I have all 3 caravan guards in my hand and was waiting for my opponent to play an attack, but unfortunately, caravan guards remain at ease for this turn. It's no big deal though, I can still play them and get the money out of them next turn. So here, magpie, magpie, caravan guard. I play magpie before caravan guard here. I'm not really sure why, but it worked out. Here now, I will have to call a royal carriage on a caravan guard so that I'm able to play my hunting grounds without drawing anything dead. I look for a magpie here because I'd rather call the royal carriage on a magpie. If I call it on a caravan guard, it'll stay out with that card. I won't have the opportunity to put it back in my deck right away then. Anyways, I managed to get the hunting grounds played with an action to spare. I play my Noble Brigand, managed to steal a silver, which is good, it's fine, it's not instrumental in any way to my strategy though. And here I have $7. I could have called a Royal Carriage on my Noble Brigand, but I would really rather leave that to gain plus actions off either magpies or caravan guards to make sure that my terminals are played rather than left dead in my hand. So here I'm thinking about training, obviously, as you can see, and I do decide to buy training and put it on the magpies, and this turns out to be an amazing thing to do. I have six of the magpies, so that's $6 automatically, and they can't be stolen by Noble Brigand. Here, I choose not to play these magpies. Don't want to trigger a reshuffle with three caravan guards plus a royal carriage plus two magpies and my explorer out of the deck. That seems very, very bad, so I just play the explorer to get a silver and come up with enough money for a province. I think I'm set now. I have money on the magpies, some in the caravan guards, I have an explorer. I feel like the attacks, the noble brigand and the taxman, they can't do anything to hurt me significantly at this point. So here, caravan guard comes out. I play my magpie. I'll have to call it. You see, I have two terminals here, so I call it. I get caravan guard in play. Well, I play hunting grounds first. Sorry. I play my caravan guard. I have a couple magpies left still. So every time they are played now, I get one money. So I already have half of the money needed for a province. I can set aside this royal carriage very safely. I don't need the money from the explorer, so I decide to attack with the noble brigand. It turns up nothing. Managed to buy a second province here. And again, I have a good start in hand here. I have a caravan guard in case an attack is played. I have two magpies. I have royal carriages set aside. And here, my opponent asks me to resign for whatever reason. I didn't think it was totally resignable at this point, but they obviously thought differently, especially with this turn. My opponent is able to buy a province this turn. So, I don't know, maybe. I don't know the reason why, but at any rate, my opponent resigns, and that is the end of the game for today. So, thank you for watching. Feedback is welcome.